morning and welcome. Everybody hear me? My name's Carl Miller. I'm with Jingoli Power. I'm the CEO and managing partner. And I want to welcome everybody today. We're the military sponsor, so welcome to all our vets. Welcome to all the military that's here today. Welcome to everybody else. When we heard about this cause, this was easy for us. This is very personal. It's very personal for me. My grandmother, Nina Jane Long, one of five kids, if you can believe it, she graduated from college with three of her siblings right after World War I. She went on to have five boys. My dad's one of them. All five fought in World War II. Amazingly, all five came home alive. So we're all very grateful for that. She was pretty analytical. She loved to play bridge. I don't know if you know what bridge is, but you gotta have four people. It's kind of a tough card game. And I always remember the story she told us where she had a couple of her friends come over to play bridge and they needed a fourth. So they recruited my dad to play. He was 4 years old. So she taught her little boy how to play bridge. It was kind of the love of her life, that game. And as she failed due to this disease, couldn't play anymore. And it was tough on her. She was a proud woman, and it was a very, very difficult experience. She went on to pass away shortly after she got this disease. Thought that was over in my life. And then my mother, she has it now. We just put her in assisted living, and she's failing bad. So for us at Jingoli Power, and I'm sure for many of you here, this is a thing that's touched our lives. And to be here to raise money for this, to be able to give some money, to be able to get a cure, or to give people some relief, it's a very good thing. So thank everybody for being here. I'm going to turn it over now, if I can find him. Big Papa, he's going to bless the bikes. Everybody ride safe. Thank you very much.
All right. May God bless you and keep you safe on your bikes. May you encounter the risen Lord in your travels and in the freedom of the open road and in the fellowship of other bikers and each person you meet. May the Lord be with you at home and on the road and with you on your journeys. May God's mercy, grace, and love shine upon you now and forever. Amen.
Yeah. are coming. Deep below. Unexpected. To the throne. We are coming. Deep below. Unexpected. To the throne. Get popped away.
Just the queen bee. Harvard, and Mark's too modest to come up here. But Mark raised your hand. I see you walking around back there. All right. And Mark is in the smoke shop. And when I was talking to Mark about his fundraising, he said, you know, the reality is that there's a story behind every one of those contributions, right? And that really, like, we were just talking about this a minute ago, that struck me. Somebody's, you know, mother or grandmother or uncle or cousin or husband or wife. And it's really hard, excuse me, for families to watch people that they care about struggle with these diseases. And so the support that you're providing, you need to know, makes a really meaningful difference to people who need it. So give yourselves a round of applause. Another group that I want to acknowledge, of course, all the folks at Alzheimer's San Diego, Eugenia, Michelle, Annie, Noel, the entire group, Caitlin. But when we started conceived of this event 3 years ago now, we said, hey, let's do something significant that can help out an organization that needs it. And how could we do it? And we said, who wants to do another like corporate dinner? Nobody raised their hand for another dinner. But a handful of people raised their hands and said, hey, let's do something fun where we can get the biker community out there, we can do a fundraiser, we get people that don't ride, we can do a nice, you know, party at a brewery. And some of those people are here. I just want to ask you to come up here if you would. George Da Silva is here. Can you come up, George? Colleen is here. Bruce, come up here. Bruce and someone, come on, Bruce. Come on, Bruce. Who else is here that was part of the very first event? Yeah, Mullen's not here. He told me he had to work and went to get some points. Anybody else in the room? Jeff Shea was part of it. Is Jeff still here? They were here. I think they rolled up. Anyway, I just want to really thank you and the handful of others that started the first SD Rides for ALZ. It's pretty awesome what you guys were able to do. So thank you very much. The last thing that I would like to do on the first event, some of you met my mom. You know, everybody loves their mother, right? It's better than your mom, nobody. And my mom was incredible. She was fierce and strong and independent. And at the first ride, some of you might remember, she was able to walk up and say thank you. And mean it in her heart, thank you. Last year, right here, she couldn't walk. She couldn't walk right here. So we brought her up in a wheelchair. And she couldn't say thank you. This year, she's not here. We lost her memory. And she's just one of the many stories that Mark talked about, right? And so I just want to say from my family to each of you, thank you for supporting Alzheimer's San Diego.
Helped us get this event to where it is right now. And so we
Hey, I just want to say thank you to Alzheimer for sending you Eugenia, it's been a pleasure working with you and Noel and Michelle. You guys make it so easy, and you're very professional and dedicated. So join me in a big round of applause for Alzheimer. Here has participated in all three Rides events. If you participate in all three Rides events, please raise your hand. Right on. Thank you. Thank you for your continued support. Look forward to seeing you next year. Any active duty military and veterans in the room? Stand up. Okay, this next group committed to raising more than $1,000 each for Alzheimer's San Diego. We call them the Full Throttle Riders. If you're a Full Throttle Rider in the room, please raise your hand and stand up. Okay, as you guys know, there's a committee that meets monthly, sometimes more than monthly, in order to make this happen. There's a lot of logistics that goes on in this event. Every year it gets bigger. There's added challenges for safety and fundraising, and the route was a concern that we changed up a little bit this year. So we had a committee called the Rides4Alz Committee that met monthly. And if you're on that committee, please raise your hand, stand up. Let's give a big round of applause. Okay, so you know this started about a little over three years ago when Scott Drury decided to combine his passion for motorcycles with his compassion for Alzheimer's. And I was talking with Scott a couple of weeks ago and I said, Scott, how does it feel to see what you've done and what you started and how it's grown and gotten bigger every year? And he immediately deflected all of the credit to you guys. He said, no, that's you guys, that's the sponsors. That's the volunteers that's making that happen. So I just want to say thank you to you, Scott. We could have done this without you. Thank you for being here. Okay, so if you were here last year, you got the long version. I'll give you the short version this time. You guys know why I arrived at this event. My mother-in-law and indeed our family was affected by this event. She ended up in a full-time care facility, where I witnessed a level of care and compassion from complete strangers that I didn't know existed. And I guess it's safe to say that it basically shamed me into service. I had to get plugged in somewhere and do something. So that's why I'm here. I've talked with many of you. I know you feel the same way. I urge all of you to get plugged in and do something, somewhere where you can give back to the community. I just want to say, as my mom always said to me, who's in the room right here right now, she said, you think you've got problems, start helping other people. Right? So, with that, I want to thank Emil Smith for putting up with us for a couple years in a row and buying drinks. Hope everybody got some round of applause. I'd like everybody to join me in a toast. Okay, it goes like this. Here's to you and here's to me. May we never disagree. But if by chance we do, then here's to me and the hell with you. Thank you, everybody. Look forward to seeing you next year.